In this video, we're taking a look at Hyundai's BlueLink infotainment and navigation system. We are in a top-end Hyundai Santa Fe Sport with the optional 8-inch touchscreen and navigation system. This is relatively similar to other Hyundai models. It's also relatively similar to the Genesis in terms of the overall software, but the interface is a little bit different. While other manufacturers have been trying to reduce their button count on their displays, Hyundai has actually been increasing theirs slightly. Up here we have an eject button, single-slot optical player, clock button that displays the clock right there on the screen, direct access buttons for phone, info, route, setup, etc. Track up, down, media button, satellite button, AM, FM button, map, voice button, destination button, enter button, tune buttons right over there. And then down here we have our climate control buttons. There's some below your screen, but I'm showing you these because it does display climate control information right here on the screen. We're now focused primarily on the screen, so let's look over the features one at a time. First off, we have the phone interface. This is your fairly stereotypical Bluetooth phone interface. We don't have messaging support in the system, but we do have a nice keypad right over here. I find that very handy to enter numbers in the system. If we move over to the info button, that's where you'll find XM data, GPS data. We have our BlueLink system as well. That's where you can get eco-driving information for the vehicle. We also have system information, and then we have location sharing and downloaded points of interest. Those two are not enabled because I don't have a device paired that would do those features. On the info button, we have XM data, we have GPS info, we have system help, and we also have BlueLink features like location sharing, downloaded points of interest, eco-driving, this gives you your fuel economy over the last few minutes, and system information for the overall system. Map information is right here behind this little door on an SD card that gives you faster mapping compared to some of the hard drive products out there. The route button is, as you can see, used for canceling a route, giving you route options, editing routes, avoiding areas, detours, etc. It's not for entering a destination. For that, you would actually use the destination button right down there. Let's first move on over to setup. This is where you can change system options like phone, HD radio, display, navigation, traffic, voice recognition, all those sorts of things. Very configurable system. Again, we have our dedicated track forward and backward buttons, dedicated AM/FM button. If we press that, it'll take you on over to that input. Separate satellite button rather than using a combined radio button, as you can see right there. Satellite radio is very easy to interact with. We have our menu, you can search for a station right there, 115 for instance, and that's CNN, and then we hit done. You can also go by category. You can also use the list right there, and you can scroll through the list. I press that again, it should pop up, there you go. And then you can scroll around on the list with the touchscreen. For some reason, I kept wanting to use this knob as a scroll wheel, but this is actually the volume knob in the system. Same sort of thing goes on in media. If we hit the media button, we have Bluetooth audio, auxiliary input, CD player, we have no disc in there right now, USB music, USB images, and our iPod interface, as well as built-in music. We have album art in the system. If we hit the menu button, we have repeat, shuffle, info on. Now, pressing this list button is how you'll browse your device. We have playlists, artists, albums, genres, etc. Complete interaction with your USB or your iDevice. You can also adjust settings right there on your iDevice itself. It doesn't lock out the screen. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that unlike options from General Motors, Ford, Toyota, as well as Honda, you cannot voice command specific songs on your USB or your iDevice. You can't just hit a button and say, play artist Madonna and have it play. If we click over here to the map, that's where you'll see your mapping interface in the system. Again, you interact with it with the touchscreen rather than a control knob. So we have our map direction right there. We have our zoom level. You can zoom in and out. We have our voice command on off button right there. Menu button. This is where you can recalculate, add waypoints, cancel routes, etc. Points of interest, XM traffic right there on the screen. You can get a list of traffic by category or by distance. We can expand or collapse this bottom menu. So you can see right now we have our road displayed right there. Again, we hit the destination button if you actually want to enter a destination, address, point of interest, name, gas station, restaurants, point of interest, etc. There's also another page for intersection searches, phone number searches, coordinate searches. Voice commands in this system overall worked very well. However, again, it does not have voice commands for your USB or your iDevice, and we only have one USB port in the Santa Fe Sport. A lot of the other vehicles in this segment are starting to have multiple USB ports, especially the My Ford Touch system, which does have two. Overall, the system is very intuitive. It's very easy to use once you figure out the lay of the buttons. We do have a decent number of buttons down here rather than on-screen commands. However, in terms of feature functionality, I do have to rank most of the other systems a little bit higher than this, especially the ones from Toyota, Honda, and Ford, because they have advanced voice commands for your USB or your iDevice, and it does work very well. Chrysler's Uconnect is probably my favorite entry in this segment, but I'm not exactly sure if I would call the Journey competition with the Santa Fe Sport that we're in right now. My Ford Touch is very fully featured. However, it is a little bit sluggish. The system is never sluggish. It never froze during my time with the system, and therefore on that ranking, it does receive top marks. Thanks for taking the time to check out this video. I'm Alex Dykes. Go ahead and click that subscribe banner at the bottom of your screen. You'll also have an option at the end of this video to go on over to the Hyundai Santa Fe Sport Review. That's the vehicle that we're taking a look at right now. Let me know what you think about this Santa Fe Sport infotainment system down there in the comment section down below. Find me over at facebook.com/alexnautos, over at Twitter as alexnautos, and I'll see you next week.